But part four of this rental lot, I wasn't quite sure what to do on the outside, so I used the park and play shelter from Discovery University to kind of house some bikes. So on the left and right corners of the front of the house, there are bikes that I'm hoping Sims will autonomously be able to use. In the back, I added some more things for children to play with, some more of the creative activity tables, so that the Sims have a little bit more of an opportunity to play. I'm hoping that making the outside a shared space is a good decision, that Sims will actually go to that space. I also wanted to use a feature from Discovery University that I feel like from high school years, that I feel like I never use, which is the easy exit window. So in The Sims 4 high school years, teenage Sims are able to sneak in and out of this window if they get a certain event trait that pops up, like if they're a party Sim and they get invited to like sneak out to go to a party. I never really use this feature, to be honest with you, but I think since this is the theme of this house is to have it be for Sims of all ages, and I do expect teen Sims to be a part of this play, it kind of made sense. So I put a bunch of the easy windows out, made a little ledge, and then used the stairs that look like a trellis, so they have the leaves in it from high school years, as the way that they're going to sneak out through the side and run through the front. I will have to play test this because I'm not 100% sure if that's going to work. So in addition to the outside of the house, I'm going to start working on the basement. So the basement is going to be a shared space within this home. The inside, of course, is not decorated yet, and I haven't marked off the units yet, but I definitely want there to be this shared basement. So the outside was basically for the children. I want the basement to be basically for the adults, and so also a shared space where adults can gather together. So what I did here was I just lit up the basement because obviously there's no windows and it's super dark down there. I didn't want the lights to be super huge, so I did use some cheats to like reduce the size of each light fixture so it's not super distracting while they're hanging from the ceiling, but provide enough light so that the whole thing has even lighting. So the basement's going to be a combination of about four rooms. The first room's going to be a laundry room. So typically, I don't use the laundry pack when I'm playing The Sims 4, but I may have a laundry basket in each bedroom. I'm not sure yet. But instead of trying to put a laundry mat in each unit, I think it's better to just have it in the basement, and then Sims can decide whether they want to do laundry by hand or just use the washer and the dryer and try to do it that way. And then if they want to wait and watch the laundry, they can, and they can talk to each other. Or if they just want to drop the laundry and go, totally an option as well. So this is the first of like two or three rooms in the basement. And we'll have to lock the doors to make sure that older Sims are the only ones who can get in here, because I don't want a bunch of children like playing in these rooms. Let me know what you think so far.